went by like a tiny little snowflake slowly floating from the sky. Oh, there are wonders never ceasing, created by our master's hand. But the greatest of all our fortune is in God's promised land. All the rich man with all of his money, all his silver and all his gold, oh, he can't buy one breath of life or a home for his weary soul. For it is bought and it is paid for by the blood of the blessed Lamb. But the greatest of all our fortune is in God's promised land.
Admirers of Ola Belle Reed describe her music as bluegrass, folk, country, or traditional. Ola Belle calls it hillbilly. A mountain woman, she was one of 13 children raised on Baptist hymns, mountain ballads, and fiddle tunes in Ashe County, North Carolina. Today, she, her husband Bud, and son David carry on the family's musical traditions at their home in Rising Sun, Maryland.
My grandfather had the first telephone that I remember in that area, and it was on the wall, and it was a crank phone. And sometimes we'd take the receiver down, and not many people had phones, but we'd take the receiver down and sing to them on the phone. And I guess we just sang. We sang if we was working. No particular time. And my mother used to sing when she was cooking or anything. You could hear her sing.
Did you teach David?
David, I think it just comes natural for people that's... We've always had musicians here. Sometimes we have the house full, you can't even get in, picking and singing, and they'll watch each other. If they haven't played that kind, they'll watch the chords, you know, and follow the other person. They go from one chord to another. We have music nearly all the time here.
You like to see this, the kids really picking
this
up?
Yes, I like to see the kids getting together with their different kind, to show you the different kinds of culture shouldn't separate people, too.
Music to me is it's love, and if we all work together, regardless of whether you're a little man behind the scenes or where you are, if you're working together, I think that's what makes it so great.
This next song is I think it's the story of the Doubting Thomas. I'm not positive who wrote it, but we learned it off of an album of the Stanley Brothers, and it does have that old mountain sound of the Primitive Baptist or the Hardshell Baptist, and it's called I Am the Man, Thomas.
Cross, Thomas, I am the man. Yes, died on the cross, come, I am the man. Yes, I am the man, come, I am the man. Look at these nail scars here in my hand.
And it would be hard for me just to say where and when that I got started, because we always sang and always played, not particularly what you'd call professionally, but people didn't have as many things to entertain them as they do nowadays, so I guess we sang mostly and played for our own enjoyment, you know.
That song that I've endured, I mean, that sounds like it's sort of biographical. I mean,
that's one
you sang, and
yeah.
That must have something to do with your
yes,
life,
that's
and feelings
a,
about growing up in the mountains.
Yes, and many other people probably that I knew, you know, that had it, you might say had it harder than we did. But I often say that maybe we didn't have push buttons, you know, and that sort of thing. But what we did have, all the money in the world couldn't buy.
Born in the mountains, 50 years ago. I've been doing